What's up, y'all? Chad Brooks here. Last week, I shared a video about what does it mean to start playing offense in ministry during this time of COVID-19 and about how the most important thing that we can be doing right now is to define who is on our team. You can go back and find that first video, but this video I want to talk with you is this, and this is a little bit more of an emotional, might not be as much of a practical video, but it's about rebuilding that team. Because here's the thing, you did the work last week to figure out, just go through your data points, that sort of a thing, to understand who you've got right now at this moment. And what you're probably doing is the same thing that me and many other ministry leaders have been just discovering, is that you've got a new team right now. You've got a completely new team that you're playing with. And here's the thing, who you have right now is who you are going to win the game with. Let's say that again. Who you have right now is who you are going to win the game with. You're probably realizing how some folks have just not been part of worship or part of the life of the church in months, maybe. And, you know, there's probably some work that you need to be doing to maybe find out why that's going on, but spending a greater amount of your energy with the people you have right now is the most important thing that you can do. I was talking to a friend of mine who's at a church, and they are like in a high anxiety mode right now because instead of the 1,000 people that they normally had in worship before COVID, they've been running like 250. They're seeing 25% of their church right now, and that's terrifying. But I don't know of a single church that's seeing 100% of the people it had in February or in early March right now. And so let me ask you this question. This could be a heavy emotional thing. This could be a little terrifying, something like that. But this is what I feel is really important to ask in this manner right now, is this. What might happen if you write off every single thing you knew until this moment? Are you willing to say that the shape of ministry, the shape of your life, the shape of what your church looks like, the shape of your leadership and your focuses and all of those things is completely different now? Are you ready to say that? Because, friends, I love you, but that's the truth. The game has changed. COVID is here. It's like that drunk uncle everybody's family has. Like, you don't know when he's going to show up, but he might show up. And if he shows up, there's no telling what might happen. But COVID is here. And so what we do now is where we begin rewriting the story of what does it mean to follow Jesus in the spaces where we are in right now. And so just one thing I want you to understand, one concept I want you to begin thinking about is this. Every church now is a church plant. Every church is new. Every church has a people they have an understanding of, they're having with them, but the game has been completely rewritten. One of the things that I do know about church plants, I do know about new church starts, I've done them before, and I've done them well, and I've done them not well, but I feel like I'm enough of an authority to talk about that. And so just a couple of things, just lessons from church planting that every single one of us needs to be aware of right now. The first thing is, how are you going to be getting new contacts in COVID? If you have got a new team you're playing with, you're going to have to start doing team recruitment. How do you find new contacts? Those new contacts are the only thing they know is going to be this new reality you invite them into. I shared a story in the first episode about this really bad flag football team I was on in middle school, and how it took us several games before we ever scored a touchdown or before we even got our first down. And the biggest change agents inside of that were when our coach realized a couple of games into the season, there's a couple of athletic kids at the school that have never played football before and are not your typical football players, But we just need some athleticism right now, and they changed the game. That's who got us our first down, got us our first touchdown. We learned go find the kid who's a great soccer player and learn what does it mean for him to become your kicker. Go find the kid who plays basketball and is like 6'4", and realize that in middle school football, that height is a serious advantage. And they're already good at catching a ball. All they're going to do now is catch the ball and not dribble it. But you're going to be making new contacts inside of this season, and you need to be thinking about, how do I make those new contacts? How do I now do my ministry in a way with my own personal evangelism or just community involvement or incarnational ministry to where I am meeting new people? I would encourage you to set a goal to interact with 5 new people a week or 10 new people a week. And you can do this on social. You can do this in the ways that face-to-face things are happening. But this is, we're here for the long haul now. You're going to have to learn what this looks like. The second thing that I think is extremely important in churches right now is you're going to have to figure out a hybrid assimilation strategy. What does it mean for new people to come to your church, whether it's online or whether it's physical? And you know what? I think every church those first few weeks of COVID was crazy excited about, oh, wow, we've got all these people coming. This is so exciting. For those of us like my church who had never done live streaming before, we had not thought about what does it mean to actually lead those people into life with Jesus alongside of our church. And we pivoted very quickly to think about that. But I want to encourage you to think about this. Like, how are you going to integrate new people into your church if they show up physically for the first time or if they show up digitally for the first time? How are you going to be getting that information? How are you inviting them into things? How are you welcoming? What does it mean to welcome someone who has worshiped with your church for consecutive Sundays digitally that you have never had a face-to-face interaction with? What does it mean to welcome them that? But then also, what does it mean to invite them to partner alongside of your church in the ministry that you feel Jesus has called y'all to? Every church is going to have to begin developing just strategies for hybrid new visitors and what that looks like. And I think that you're going to see the churches that manage to rise through this are the ones that will have adapted quickly and realized it's a lot harder to assimilate someone digitally than it is physically. And if you didn't have a physical assimilation pathway developed already, you can begin from, you need to start working on that. And so that's kind of it. That's the second video. I think we're probably 4 videos in this series of just what does it mean to start playing offense in ministry during COVID. And this one's been about just learning that you've got a new team. The next video is going to be about measuring things. How do we begin measuring things in a way that matters and that actually shows us where we're doing good or where we might not be doing good in COVID? That's going to be next week or several days down the road. These are probably popping out every 4 or 5 days instead of every week. But I'm Chad Brooks. Thanks for letting me jump into your feed today, wherever you watch this and have this conversation with you. I would love to hear back from you. If this is showing up in a place where I can see it, just drop something down in the comments. I would love to hear from you, interact with you, and I will see you next time.